Okay, so now that we have seen two types of dependencies and how can they affect the scheduling of instructions in a process that is trying to do more than an instruction per cycle, let's do a dependency quiz. Let's say we have a processor with a classical five-stage pipeline, meaning that in one cycle it fetches, then reads registers and decodes, then executes, then performs a memory access, and finally writes registers. Let's also say that the processor has forwarding that can, if the result has been produced, it's gonna feed it to the instruction correctly, even though maybe the result has not been written to a register yet. But the result has to have been produced, meaning that the instruction that produces the result had to either finish the execute stage if the result is something like a plus, or had to finish the memory stage if this is a load instruction. So we can basically then feed that result to the instruction that executes in the next cycle without having to wait for the producing instruction to get to the write register stage, just as we discussed before. And finally, let's say that this processor can execute 10 instructions in each stage. So theoretically, it could in one cycle fetch 10 instructions, then decode all 10, then execute all 10 if there are no dependencies and so on. So in five cycles, it's going to execute all 10 instructions. If we have 20 instructions, the first 10 would be fetched in the first cycle. It would immediately in the next cycle fetch the next 10. So theoretically, it would be able to finish all 20 in six cycles because we have to still get to the write rec stage. The question is, when do we execute and write back each of these instructions? So we have these six instructions, and the question is, when do we execute? And to help you get started, let's say that the very first cycle is cycle zero. So that is when we fetch the mul. It reads registers in cycle one, so it will execute definitely in cycle two. Also, because the add here is using R2, it has to wait for the mul to execute, and then forwarding will produce the mul's value to the add. So the add has to wait and execute in cycle three. If you look at the mul, because it has executed in cycle 2, it will go through the mem stage in cycle 3 and write its result in cycle 4. The question is, when are these others, in what cycles are they producing and writing the results?